This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the two variances that are associated with fixed manufacturing overhead. Many organizations do analyze fixed manufacturing overhead, and they'll take a look at a couple of variances to try to figure out why costs differed from what was expected in the budget. There are two separate variances associated with fixed manufacturing overhead, as you see here. The first is the spending variance, which really analyzes whether we spent more or less than we expected to spend on our fixed overhead. And fixed overhead, these are costs that, for example, would be related to the factory, could be the rent on the factory, maybe we pay for insurance related to the factory. Those would be fixed overhead examples. And the spending variance really is looking at whether we spent more or less than we expected to spend on those types of items. And then we have a second variance, and it's the fixed overhead production volume variance. And this has to do with whether we produced more product than we expected to produce, and it'll come out of this variance. And we'll talk about that in more detail in just a second. Let's start with the fixed overhead spending variance. What is it and how do we calculate it? I talked a little bit about it in the first slide, that the fixed overhead spending variance is the difference between the actual fixed overhead costs and the budgeted fixed overhead costs. So it's pretty straightforward. What are the actual costs associated with fixed overhead? What did we expect those costs to be? And let's take the difference. And whatever that difference is, that is our spending variance. If the actual costs are higher than the budgeted costs, then it's an unfavorable variance. If the actual costs are lower than the budgeted costs, then it's a favorable variance. The fixed overhead costs are typically not driven by a specific activity. And this is different than when we looked at the other variances in separate lectures, the direct materials variances, the direct labor variances, the variable manufacturing overhead variances. Those are usually driven by some specific level of activity, some type of activity. Fixed overhead costs are not as easily linked to a specific activity. So our third bullet point here, managers have to review then the detail of the actual costs and the budgeted costs to find out why is there a difference. If we have a favorable or unfavorable variance, it takes some real investigation and diving into the records to try to figure out why those actual costs are higher or lower than expected. Now we'll take a look at the fixed overhead production volume variance. So the fixed overhead production volume variance is the difference between the budgeted fixed overhead costs, and I use the term fixed overhead and fixed manufacturing overhead interchangeably. So it's the difference between the budgeted overhead fixed overhead costs and the applied fixed overhead costs. Most companies will apply fixed overhead to products based on some method. It could be that they base it on direct labor hours or machine hours, or it could be an activity-based costing type of a system. And the fixed overhead production volume variance really is simply the difference between what we had budgeted for our fixed overhead cost and what we had applied to our products. And that's what you see right down here in this formula. So the fixed overhead production volume variance, last bullet point here, is typically the direct result of the difference in volume between budgeted production, what we expected to produce, and actual production, what we actually produced. Let's take a look at a more detailed example of this on the next slide. So we're going to work from left to right here with this fixed manufacturing overhead variance analysis. On the left, you'll see that we have actual fixed overhead costs, and our actual fixed overhead costs amounted to $136,000. In the middle column, you'll see that we had the flexible budget. This is where we present the flexible budget for our fixed overhead costs. And that flexible budget amounts to $140,280. And there's lots of detail in the footnotes down below, so you can take a look at those if you want to know where these numbers come from. And as we move our way to the right, over on the far right, we're looking at fixed overhead costs that were applied to the products. The assumption in this example is that we apply our fixed overhead based on direct labor hours. So you can see that in the footnotes again. You can dive into the footnotes to see where those numbers come from. And the total fixed overhead costs that were applied to products is $147,000. So let's go back over to the left, and we'll take a look at the fixed overhead spending variance, which turns out to be favorable. Well, the flexible budget says that we expected to spend $140,280. We expected cost of $140,280 related to our fixed overhead. Turns out actual costs were $136,000. So we have a $4,280 favorable fixed overhead spending variance. And as I mentioned before, we'd need to dive into the records to find out why our actual overhead costs were lower than the flexible budget, what we expected to see in fixed overhead costs. And then as we move our way over to the right here, we see the production volume variance. And the production volume variance is the difference between our flexible budget, that's right here, the $140,280, and the fixed overhead costs that were applied to our products of $147,000. The difference in these two numbers is related strictly to the number of units that were produced and sold, which was 210,000 units. If you look in the footnotes, you'll see that. And that's how overhead costs are applied, versus the 200,400 units that were budgeted to be produced, and that's related to the flexible budget. So again, it's production volume variance, and it really is very descriptive, that variance name, because this variance relates directly to production volume. We produced more units than we expected to produce, and therefore we applied more fixed overhead costs than were in the flexible budget. And as a result, we have, as you see here, a $6,720 favorable fixed overhead production volume variance.